That's right, still the one, FlightCheck. And this was a little chat we were having on a sidebar within a live presentation by Mordy. And Mordy is a former product manager for Adobe Illustrator and now a certified Adobe trainer and expert.
Called Design Responsibly.
And has his own site. And every Friday gives a live demonstration. Last Friday was Illustrator and Prepress, where he covered FlightCheck and preflighting and packaging, which is not native to Illustrators. These are very important things to know about. So check out what I have screen recorded here. The quality is a lot less than if you log in yourself or watch the recorded version, which I'll link to, because it's a really educational show on design and production and all kind of cool stuff about Illustrator and technology. So check it out. Fridays with Mordy. And yes, FlightCheck is still the one. Download the free 30-day demo version and try it out today. Thank you. David from Markzware. Check it out here a little bit on Mordy and his show.
Very strongly go by. If you work a lot in print, it's called Real World Print Production. It's written by a friend of mine. Her name is Mordy McHugh. And it's an excellent book. It's not a really thick book. It doesn't have to be. But if you are working in the world of print, you need to get this book because it is a fantastic book. it gives you a whole bunch of information about everything you would need to know about the print process. What I want to focus on today, though, is how Illustrator kind of fits into that workflow. What can you do inside of Illustrator to kind of make sure that you don't fall into any traps, you avoid some pitfalls, that you know what to look out for, and hopefully it'll save you some money. That's my hope, hopefully to save you some time. And the great thing is that we're going to talk a little bit about pre-flighting your documents also. That's kind of just, you know, making sure your document is correct, collecting for output. And then there's another company called Markzware, which is a plugged in board that has the characters, and we can just, you know, write, zip through a document to make sure that everything's okay with it. For a sanity check or other things like that as well, it really can be very powerful. And we'll actually show you. I'm going to test all of you a little quick. All right. So let's launch Illustrator here, and let's talk a little bit about this. And remember, as always, you guys know the rules of the game. Use InDesign. There's a built-in packaging command inside of InDesign. There's also our preflight command. But again, like I said before, the limits about what the preflight and packaging does instead of InDesign is that you have to have the document open and you can do one document at a time. If you're working a lot with a lot of documents and you want to be able to preflight and really kind of sanity check on your documents, flight check is actually just ref version is 6.5, which I'm going to open up right now, I'll show you. I'm going to choose open here to open up a file that I want to work with. I'm going to open up multiple Illustrator. And I just want to show you now, it's kind of good. It's going to pre-flight my documents and go through and analyze the document. It's not just collecting the file. In fact, it's not part of it. I want to be able to, right now, you see a whole list of text that, if you're wrong, there, one of the images. It's a low-res 72 DPI image, right? Yeah, the bird still, you know, gives you a little quack when it actually finishes doing this. But you can see on the bottom here, it gave me an information. It's an overview. It tells you to overview if there are blends that exist in the document. It tells you if there's RGB artwork inside every document. So this gives you information about your document before it goes ahead and collects it. So in this case over here, and it gives you, by the way, a warning on the bottom. It tells you what the actual issue is. So I know that I need to change the resolution. I just want to show you how it's very quickly. If I go back into Illustrator and I see, oh, here's that image. So I can actually use the, I'm gonna click on this. This is a mask. I happen to have a high-res version of this image. I was just using a low-res for position. But now I have a high-res version I can work with. I'm going to choose to relink it to the high-res version. And it will just automatically update it in place. And now I have the high-res image of that. That inside of my file. I'll save my file. And when I'm done with this, I'll just say collect. And again, I'll put my desktop over here. And there's some other options. I'm just going to use the default setting. And if I go now to my desktop, you see that I have the folder, that it has a folder, it has the image folder, and it has the thing here as well. So those are two potential options that you can use to kind of help you out.